lines. I wanted to get to my friends and boast that I had recaptured the ship single-handedly. In high spirits, I set out for the stockade, and before long, I was near the hill where I'd first encountered Ben Gunn.
I must stay alert, I thought. I don't want my friends to shoot me by mistake.
As the moon climbed higher, the glow appeared among the trees again. As I drew near, I heard my friends snoring, peaceful in their sleep, and the unpleasant noises sounded like music to me.
If Long John was creeping in on them like this, my friends would all be dead by daybreak.
Pieces of meat!
Long John's parrot!
I whispered. My body froze with fear as the sleepers awoke and jumped up.
Who goes there?
John. One of the pirates left the log house and returned with a long piece of burning wood. His pipe.
Now, Jim, I've always liked you. You remind me of myself when I was young. I always hoped you'd join me and my men, and now I think you must. The captain doesn't want to see you again, and I heard the doctor call you an ungrateful scamp. So you can't go back to your friends.
My friends are still alive,
I thought joyfully.
Your fate is in our hands,
continued Long John.
But I never threaten. If you like our company, you'll join. If you don't, Jim, why, you're free to answer no.
Well,
I said, growing a bit bolder.
Choose,
replied Long John.
Well, there's something I need to tell you first.
Speak, boy,
ordered Long John.
A ship has been lost. Treasure lost, men lost, and all your plans have been ruined. If you want to know who did it, it was me. I was in the apple barrel when we sighted land, and I heard you, Long John, and you, Dick Johnson, and Israel Hands, who's now at the bottom of the sea, and I told the captain every word. I cut the ship's anchor line and killed the men aboard. Kill me or spare me.
By thunder, I have a chance.
He hobbled to the torch and lit his pipe again.
Understand me, Jim,
he said, returning to his seat.
I'm on the Squire's side now, because I know you've got that ship safe somewhere. I'll ask no questions, and I won't tell the others. Ah, you are so young. You and I might have done a powerful amount of good together.
He poured himself some brandy.
Why did that doctor give me the map, Jim?
I looked so surprised that he knew I had no idea what he was talking about.
Ah, he did,
said he.
There's some reason why, no doubt. Some reason, surely, Jim, bad or good.
Long John took a swallow of the brandy and shook his head like a man who looks forward to the worst kind of luck.